Hominini. Hominini, also called African hominids or African apes, is a subfamily of Hominidae. It includes two tribes, with their extant as well as extinct species: (1) the Hominini tribe, with the genus Homo including modern humans, Australopithecina, comprising at least three extinct, or, fossil, genera, and the genus Pan, chimpanzees, including common chimpanzees and bonobos; (2) the Gorillini tribe, gorillas. It comprises all hominids that arose after orangutans, subfamily Pongini, split from the line of great apes. The Hominini cladogram has three main branches, which lead to gorillas, through the tribe Gorillini, and to humans and chimpanzees via the tribe Hominini and subtribes Hominina and Panina. See the evolutionary tree below. There are two living species of Panina, chimpanzees and bonobos, and two living species of gorillas, but only one extant human species. Traces of hypothetical Homo species, including Homo floresiensis and Homo denisova, have been found with dates as recent as 40,000 years ago. Organisms in this subfamily are described as hominin or hominins, not to be confused with the terms hominins or hominini. Until 1980, the family and term Hominidae meant humans only. The non-human great apes were assigned to the family Pongidae. Later discoveries led to revised classifications, with the great apes then united with humans, now in subfamily Hominini. As members of family Hominidae, further discoveries indicated that gorillas and chimpanzees are more closely related to humans than they are to orangutans, leading to their gorillas and chimpanzees placement in subfamily Hominini as well. The subfamily Hominini can be further subdivided into three branches: the tribe Gorillini, gorillas, and the tribe Hominini, with subtribes Panina, chimpanzees, and Hominina, humans and their extinct relatives. The late Miocene fossil Nokalopithecus nakayamai, described in 2007, is a basal member of this clade, as is, perhaps, its contemporary Auranopithecus. That is, they are not assignable to any of the three extant branches. Their existence suggests that the Hominini tribes diverged not earlier than about 8 million years ago. See human evolutionary genetics. Today, chimpanzees and gorillas live in tropical forests with acid soils that rarely preserve fossils. Although no fossil gorillas have been reported, four chimpanzee teeth about 500,000 years old have been discovered in the East African Rift Valley, Kopthiran Formation, Kenya, where many fossils from human lineage, hominins, have been found. This shows that some chimpanzees lived close to Homo, H. erectus or H. rhodesiensis, at the time. The same is likely true for gorillas. Hominini. The age of the subfamily Hominini, of the Hominini Pongini last common ancestor, is estimated at some 14 to 12.5 million years, Cervopithecus. Its separation into Gorillini and Hominini, the gorilla-human last common ancestor, Glca, is estimated to have occurred at about t. during the late Miocene, close to the age of Nokalopithecus nakayamai. There is evidence there was interbreeding of gorillas and the Pan-Homo ancestors until right up to the Pan-Homo split. Recent studies of Ardipithecus ramidus, 4.4 million years old, and Auroran tugenensis, 6 million years old, suggest some degree of bipedalism. Australopithecus and early Paranthropus may have been bipedal. Very early hominins such as Ardipithecus ramidus may have possessed an arboreal type of bipedalism. There have been a gradual increase in brain volume, brain size, as the ancestors of modern humans progressed along the timeline of human evolution, starting from about 600 centimeters in Homo habilis up to 1,500 centimeters in Homo neanderthalensis. However, modern Homo sapiens have a brain volume slightly smaller, 1,250 centimeters, than Neanderthals. Women have a brain slightly smaller than men, and the Flores hominids, Homo floresiensis, nicknamed hobbits, had a cranial capacity of about 380 centimeters, considered small for a chimpanzee, about a third of the Homo erectus average. It is proposed that they evolved from H. erectus as a case of insular dwarfism. In spite of their smaller brain, there is evidence that H. floresiensis used fire and made stone tools at least as sophisticated as those of their proposed ancestors H. erectus. In this case, it seems that for intelligence, the structure of the brain is more important than its size. Sexuality is related to family structure and partly shapes it. The involvement of fathers in education is quite unique to humans, at least when compared to their Hominini. Concealed ovulation and menopause in women both also occur in a few other primates. However, but are uncommon in other species. Testis and penis size seems to be related to family structure, monogamy or promiscuity, or harem, in humans, chimpanzees or gorillas, respectively. The levels of sexual dimorphism are generally seen as a marker of sexual selection. Studies have suggested that the earliest hominins were dimorphic and thathies lessened over the course of the evolution of the genus Homo, correlating with humans becoming more monogamous, whereas gorillas, who live in harems, show a large degree of sexual dimorphism. Concealed, or hidden, ovulation means that the phase of fertility is not detectable in women, whereas chimpanzees advertise ovulation via an obvious swelling of the genitals. Women can be partly aware of their ovulation along the menstrual phases, but men are essentially unable to detect ovulation in women. Most primates have semi-concealed ovulation, thus one can think that the common ancestor had semi-concealed ovulation, that was inherited by gorillas, and that later evolved in concealed ovulation in humans and advertised ovulation in chimpanzees. Menopause also occurs in rhesus monkeys, and possibly in chimpanzees, but does not in gorillas and is quite uncommon in other primates and other mammal groups. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.